On Thursday, Facebook banned a group called Stop the Steal. President Trump's supporters were using the group to organize protests against vote counting. Members posted baseless claims of voter fraud. The Washington Post reports some of the efforts promoted in places like Pennsylvania and Arizona specifically target vote counting centers, threatening disruptions while ballot tallying is still underway. For more on this, let's bring in CNET senior producer Dan Patterson. Hi there, Dan. So how big was this group, and are there others like it?
Hey, good to see you, Elaine. So this particular group was about 300,000 members, and it gained traction so quickly because some of the tributary groups themselves, at least according to the Washington Post, had several hundred thousand members, including one called Women for America First, which had 100,000 members and was directly feeding into this larger group.
Well, what were the people in the group actually encouraging others to do?
Well, some of the rhetoric was fairly typical for what you would see in a grassroots organization. They were calling for donations to fund flights and hotels for boots on the ground. That might sound fairly normal, but it's not when you couple with the rhetoric that was used, much of which was very violent. And many of the members openly called for a violent civil war. So this wasn't just boots on the ground for grassroots organizing. This appeared to be, at least in the eyes of Facebook, boots on the ground for violent activity.
And that's the reason they gave for removing the group, because you and I have talked many times about how there has been such scrutiny on Facebook and other platforms this year.
Yeah, there really has been. You know, I reached out to my spokesperson at Facebook, as I have all week. I heard nothing from my typical spokesperson, but Andy Stone, who is a fairly well-known spokesperson for the company, said that the group, this Facebook group's principles, were founded around anti-democratic principles and were explicitly against or slowing down the electoral and the democratic process. And coupled with the violence that they saw in the group, this was enough for them to kind of slow down or stop this group.
So Facebook also banned the Stop the Steal hashtag on Thursday. How do you expect this kind of rhetoric online to change as we get closer to a result? Do you think that it'll slow down?
Well, Elaine, as we've talked about a few times, every time something like this happens, I speak with other experts across the cybersecurity and the disinformation sphere, and almost everybody agrees that we are entering into kind of a very dangerous window of time where the facts on the ground are one thing, but we have this incredibly animated group of people who disregard the facts and are prone to violence. And we've seen this spread through conspiracy groups like QAnon. So we see not only this violence around it, but an antipathy for the facts. And when you have that mixed with a polar opposite group of people who may have been, in this instance, the we don't know for sure, but may have won the election, we see a lot of resentment and pent-up anger. There's also a lot of threat actors, a lot of different groups who see good motivation, low stakes, and a lot to gain by spreading mis and disinformation. So it's just a very noisy and dangerous period of time online right now.
A noisy and dangerous time. So what other kinds of election-related hashtags are trending right now?
So we see, not just across Facebook, but on Twitter as well, we see tags like Stop the Steal and tags that allege voter fraud. Of course, these are totally false. And we've seen many that impugn Biden. So I use a couple of tools to kind of track what's moving at any given moment. And this is, again, a very noisy period of time because we see different types of hashtags, including pro-Biden, apparently inauthentic activity, kind of climb the charts and gain traction for short periods of time and then fall back down. So the best thing we can do is kind of watch as these groups metastasize and how they communicate with each other and kind of flag or at least monitor instances of violence. But again, it's a very chaotic period right now online.
Yeah, no shortage of stories for you to cover. Dan Patterson, thank you so much for sorting through it with us. We appreciate it.
Great to see you.